Hello.
Hi, Senator.
How are you?
I'm fine, thanks. We're with KCRA. We're the local NBC affiliate.
Wonderful.
And it's a pleasure to meet you.
Pleasure.
Where to start except the fact that we're in Solano County? I know it's your second stop here, if I'm right. Is Solano County a focus for you? And if so, why?
Well, the truth is, I love to go to rural areas. I love to go to communities where other presidential candidates never would go in a million years. And that's the nature of this campaign. We're running a grassroots campaign. We're talking to people face to face to let them know what this candidate for president believes.
How, over the next 4 days, will you make sure to get your supporters out to vote? And I ask you that question because we've looked at surveys of the vote-by-mail ballots that are coming back. And in an election when enthusiasm is high among independent voters, the independents are so far not showing up.
Well, we're going to work very, very hard in the next 4 days to get independents out, to get working people out, to get young people out, to get every voter in California out who believes that it is too late for establishment politics, who wants real change in this country and not a government that it represents the interests of the wealthy and the powerful.
And so your thoughts over the voter confusion on this independent ballot, this ballot that people are getting that doesn't have any presidential candidates listed?
I think it's unfortunate, and I would hope that California makes the appropriate changes next time around. We want to see as many people participate in the democratic process as possible. I believe in that. And any impediments to that effort must be corrected.
So, Senator, should there be more uniform voting regulations that are federal, that are nationwide?
Yes, that's a very good point. And the answer, I think, is yes. Maybe I'm old-fashioned, but I think that every person in this country who is 18 years of age or older should have the right to vote and participate in our democracy. And if elected president, that is an issue that I will work very hard on. I want us to have the highest voter turnout of any major country on earth, not one of the lowest.
Between now and Tuesday, what will you do to educate voters to ask for that Democratic ballot if they want to vote for a Democratic candidate?
We are making a whole lot of telephone calls as we speak. And we are knocking on doors, and we are doing as much as we can to address that issue.
Were you disappointed to hear that Jerry Brown endorsed Hillary Clinton?
In every single state that we have run in, which has a Democratic governor, every one of them has endorsed Hillary Clinton. With one exception, all the United States senators have endorsed Hillary Clinton. Almost all members of the House have endorsed Hillary Clinton. We are taking on the Democratic establishment, and no, I'm not surprised. I like Jerry Brown, but I'm certainly not surprised. This campaign has won 20 states up to now. We're going to win a number more on Tuesday because the people are standing up and saying, you know what, we're a little bit tired of establishment politics and establishment economics. And that's what our campaign is about.
But we have to say, Jerry Brown in 1992 ran against Bill Clinton. And he ran a campaign not unlike yours.
I remember.
So, did you ask for his endorsement? Had you hoped for it?
Look, as somebody, as a United States Senator who has endorsed many candidates, you know what? Sometimes they win and sometimes they don't. I am not overly impressed based on my own experience about the importance of endorsements. At the end of the day, the people of California are going to look at the real issues. Income inequality, the only nation on earth that doesn't have a health care system for all people, outrageously high cost of college education, and people will come up with their own conclusions, and I believe we've got a really good chance to win.
As you know, water is scarce in California.
Yep.
We've heard you talk about the California drought. What do you think of Governor Brown's plan to build these vast tunnels moving from northern to southern California?
Honestly, I just haven't had a chance to really study it, but this is what I do believe. What I do believe is that anybody who does not understand that climate change is real and is already bringing profound changes to the United States, California, and the world is dead wrong and doing a real disservice to this country. So I support any and all efforts that will transform our energy system away from fossil fuel to energy efficiency and sustainable energy.
And So California's plan to build a high-speed rail train, any thoughts on that?
Yeah, I do. I think our infrastructure is in massive need of repair. We are way behind the rest of the industrialized world in terms of a modern 21st century rail system. I support high-speed rail.
Can I have a selfie with you?
Sure.